corners of the house, and it fell upon the young men, and they all dead, and only I escaped alone to tell thee. Verse number 20. Then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground in worship and said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Lord, charge God foolishness. Heavenly Father, I thank you that I may decrease so you can increase. And God, I thank you in advance for this message. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. You may be seated. I want to set the stage today as you came in and I read the text today. I want to share with you, I give my condolence to Brother Job as you have came to pay your respects to the homegoing celebration. For Job has lost his 7 sons and his 3 daughters, and as we're here today to actually continue to climax on the lessons of grief. Grief gives us many stages of grief. Grief gives us denial. Grief gives us anger. Grief bargains, and grief gives us depressions and acceptance. And what we can find here as we are celebrating 104th church anniversary, we invited Job to come with us today to bring his 7 children and his 7 sons and his 3 daughters. He couldn't bring all the cattle. He couldn't bring all the sheep that he lost. He couldn't even imagine all the stuff that Job lost. But Job brought us to learn it from us from the express point. You may be seated just a little. And Job reminds us that as we are here today, I don't know about you, but have y'all ever lost a lot and still yet had a worship on the inside? And worship is something that we do. Worship is all about who we are. Worship is no matter what happens in our life, that we still yet got a worship on the inside. I don't know about you, but Job reminds us that in the time of need, we just need to call on the name of Jesus. I know that all of us are grieving in our text today. So for those that are taking notes, Brother Mike, if we had to give a title to the message, I would say, I lost it all, but I'm still trusting God. I don't know about you. Has anybody ever lost it all, but you can still yet trust God? Or just for some of those others that was in the valley, you would say, what do I do when I'm in the valley? So I just want to help us to remind us that this introduction is how Ben saying that Job lost everything. Yeah, many of y'all ever heard that Job lost everything during his time of affliction. It is true that he lost his family. It is true that he lost his finances. It is true that he lost his fitness. It is true that he lost his friends. But yet, through it all, he never lost his faith. Do I have a witness in the house that even though I'm grieving, I got to still have faith to know that God can make a way? I may lose all that I got, but I still got my faith. I may lose my friends. I may even lose family, but I still got my faith. Is there anybody here that can testify that when you go through the valley, you got to keep your faith? Somebody shout faith. Because I know in this series of grief, I've helped us to realize, to tell you that it's okay to grieve. It's okay to bargain with God. It's okay to deny. It's okay to even be angry. But even in my anger, I got to have the faith that God's going to make a way out of no way. I don't care what I have to go through, but I got to continue to tell myself is I got faith to trust God. Is there anybody trusting God? I know you've heard that Job lost it all, but I want to tell you that even though Job lost all the material stuff, Job never lost his faith. Is there anybody in the house that can testify, I've lost some things, but I still got my faith. I've been down, but I still got my faith. I've been through the valley, but I still got my faith. I know you're wondering. Some wondered when they came in, what does this represent? This represents to show us, because the text paints a picture to tell us that Job lost his 7 sons. I don't know which one the casket of all sons are in. I don't know which 3 of the daughters, but what I'm trying to tell you is that before us, we have 10 people that are dead, and the father is still able to praise God. I'm glad that you asked me. How can you praise God in the midst of losing all that you have? You can praise him because of the faith that you have on the inside. Somebody tell yourself, I got faith. I'm still yet in the season of grief. I'm still yet dealing with grief. I'm still yet dealing with grief. But even in the midst of my grief, I got faith to know that the Lord will make a way. somehow, even in the midst of my faith. Somebody shout faith. Somebody shout faith. When the bottom fell out of Job's life, he maintained his confidence in the Lord. In doing so, he demonstrates to us what our duty is to do to God while we pass through the valley. So even though I'm going through the valley, I still got to trust God. Everyone in this room goes through difficult times. In fact, there has never been a human's life that was free from the burdens and cares. This shouldn't surprise us, because the Bible tells us that things are going to be this way. In Job 14, verse number 1, it says, man that is born of a woman is full of troubles. His days is full of trouble. I want to tell you, one writer, Augustine, put it this way. It said, God only has one son on earth without sin, but none without suffering. Can I tell you that I don't care who you are today, you got to go through some suffering. Do I got a witness in the house? When these times come upon us, we can react in one or two ways. We can either move towards God or we can move away from God. And I'm here to tell you, Calvary, I don't care how tough it gets, I'm moving to God, not from God. Because I'm here to tell you that the Lord will make a way. I've seen some trials produce both reacting to people who have ministered over the years. I want to tell you that we have to have the attitude. Trouble affects folks different. Can I have a witness in the house? I've had some members that have lost loved ones, and I've seen them act a fool. Come on, talk to me. I've had some members that have lost loved ones, and I've seen them praise God. I'm telling you, people act and respond different. Troubles are like hot water. It sours milk, but it also sweetens apples. There's some of y'all as sweet as apples, and there's some of y'all sour as milk. And it's my conviction that trials come to help us grow in the Lord, because the Bible tells me in Romans 8 and 28, for all things work together for the good for them that love and are called according to God and his purpose. If this is the case, then it stands to reason that we are expected to carry out certain duties while we are in the valley. And as I told you before in my series, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that God is right there with you. Calvary, as we celebrate today, 104 years old, we can say that we've had our valley moment, but we can also say that God has brought us a mighty long way. What I mean is that our time in the valleys are not times to be passive, but there are times to be proactive. God has certain expectations when it comes to our attitudes and our behavior while we're in the valley. I'm here to tell you that God expects you to trust him in the valley. So if you can trust God in the valley of your sorrow, you got to know that the Lord will make a way out of no way. Can I ask Mr. Job, since I'm preaching about you today, and I know some of y'all don't see him, but Job is right there on the front row. Job can't even stay in his seat. Job is praising God. Job is telling the Lord, thank you. Job is saying, God, you have brought me a mighty long way. And how can Job do that? Mike, how can Job do what he do in the midst of all that he lost? Y'all read the text with me. The Bible says that while Job was there in his house, Job had prayed for his children, because Job knew his children were out there having a good time. So can I just suggest to some parent, you need to pray for your kids more. You need to worship your kids more. You need to sacrifice for your kids, because God has blessed you to be able to bless. And the Bible says that while Job was there, one servant came. It's amazing how God always allows someone to escape to go say what God can do. Can I get a witness in the house that God is able? I don't know about you, but God has spared your life. You've been that servant that's been able to go and tell somebody of the goodness of God. Is there anybody that can testify that God has brought you a mighty long way? Is there anybody that can testify you should have been dead and gone, but God spared your life? Is there anybody that can testify that God has brought you out of something to go tell the good news of God? So So now, in preparing this and wrestling with this message, Keisha and Zach and Stan with the series of grief, what helped Job to do this? What helped Job to get through this? What's going to help us to get through our stages of grief? And Alice says, there must be a devotion to God. When we are devoted to God, God gives us strength that we didn't even think that we had. Because some of you all sitting here today would tell me, I didn't even know how I was going to make it, but I made it. Tell anybody that can say that. Somebody can say, I made it. Tell yourself, I made it. And listen, if you're sitting here today, you made it. You made it through some things that you didn't think you were going to make it. All that Job lost, many of us would have reacted in anger and in frustration. Many would have turned on the Lord and cursed his name. Not Job. His response was going before the Lord in worship. Now the Bible tells us in Job 1 and 21, in Job 1 and 20, it says, and Job arose and ripped his clothes and shaved his head and fell down to the ground and worshiped God. Now I just want to ask you, the last time that you got some bad news, did you worship God? The last time you got a bad report, did you worship God? I got a really good dear friend of mine. I got a really, really, really good dear friend of mine. She is going through cancer right now. She's battling cancer. They told her that she had stage 4 cancer. I check on her. Try to check on her as much as I can. Every time I check on her, she's worshiping God. I sent her a message and I said, how are you doing? And she sent me back a message and she said, I've never trusted God like I've trusted God before. She said, Pastor, no matter what happened, I'm trusting God. And that's what I just want to ask somebody today. Are you really trusting God? I mean, you know, here Job. Now listen, Job had 5 different servants that came to him from every direction. And all of these servants that came to Job from every direction, none of them had any good news. But even in bad news, Job worshiped God. Now I know it's easy when I can worship God in good news. Now, Kendra, you are a counselor, so you help people. And when you help people, you know most people come to you because they want to complain and they want to whimper. But then your direction is to lead them, to help them get back into life to where they can see that there is hope. And that's all that Job was trying to show all of his servants. Job was saying, even though God has allowed this to happen, I can still yet worship God. And so Job was devoted. Not only that, his response was going before the Lord in worship. The Bible reminds us he shaved his head and ripped his clothes. Both of these acts were a sign that Job was in mourning and that he was devastated. But the fact that he worshiped proved that he was not broken. Job reminds us that in the midst of this, in the blackness of night, God is working out his plan for your life. I just want to tell somebody, if it takes you to walk through a deep, dark valley for you to grow in the Lord, then it has to run its course, because sometimes God allows us to go through our pain in order to find our purpose. Is there anybody in the house that have had some pain, but in your pain you found your purpose? I don't know about you. But can I tell you, and you already know this, but can I tell them again, Mother Toon, you can depend on God. Can I say that again? You can depend on God. Somebody tell yourself, say it, you can depend on God. You know why you can depend on God? Because the word says in Hebrews 13 and 5, the word says he will never fail you nor forsake you. He will come through you. He will come through for you. I don't know about you, but God's always came through to me. I was trying to write a list in this message. I was trying to write a list because I done been through some things. I done been through some trials and some tribulations. And I was trying to figure out, have I ever been through anything that God did not show up? And what I've come to find out is after all the things I've been through, God's always been right. That's what I've come to find out. God has always, always been there. And can I tell you what? And us as Baptist folks, why trust when you worry? Can I say that again? Why trust when you worry? Yet the Bible teaches us for a different approach. The Bible asks, why worry when you can trust? Why you worry when you know you can trust God? Worry is of the enemy. Worry is of the devil. Worry is what comes to make you try and take you off your course. Why are you worry when you can trust God? Now I told him, Pastor Snoddy, in the 9 o'clock session sermon, I told him, I said, I ain't bragging, but can I brag on God? I said, cause you know what? I ain't got nothing to worry about. Keisha, I ain't got nothing to worry about. You know why? Cause I'm trusting God. How many know when you're trusting God, you ain't got to worry? You ain't got to worry how you're going to pay your bills, because God's going to supply all your needs. You ain't got to worry how you're going to get through it, because the Lord is your shepherd. The Bible reminds us that Job was a devoted God. Job was devoted to God. Then I want to also tell you, not only was Job devoted to God, that Job depended on God. How many's going to depend on God? How many going to depend on God? Is there anybody here that can depend on God? We ought to ask ourselves, what is it that would make me turn on God? There ain't nothing that would make me turn on God. When Job considered this, his response is recorded in Job 13 and 5. Job said that even if the Lord take his life, he will still trust in the Lord. What about you? Are you trusting God? Remember, this season is a season of grief. And in our season of grief, we got to still yet trust God. We got to trust God. We need to remember that the pearls, which is so prized and valuable, is the product of suffering. Do you know what brings your value today? Your suffering. The reason you're so valuable today is because of what you've been through. I don't care what you've been through. God brought you through it for a reason. There would be no pearls where there is no pain. So it is the kingdom of God's brightest star, and those who have endured the most suffering, when trouble comes, be like the vine, cling to the tree. If the wind blows one way, you will be sheltered from the force. If the wind blows the other way, it will only serve to press you closer to the Lord. I don't know about you, but I like it when the wind blows. Because if it blows the right direction, it blows me to the Lord. In other words, can I tell you, never quit. Tell yourself, say, I'm not a quitter. He said, I'm not a quitter. What we really need to do is to stop and consider all that Jesus suffered for us and the great price that was paid for our redemption. When these things are kept in the forefront of our mind, then it's impossible to quit on the Lord. Now, I know we're celebrating 104 years. I've been here 23 years. I can tell you that in those 23 years, I have wrote several resignation letters. But in all those resignation letters, I had to tear them up. Because when I begin to think of where God has brought me from and how good God has been to me, I had to say, they didn't call me, God called me. So I got to keep on serving the Lord, because serving the Lord will pay off after a while. Tell you, there must be a devotion to God. There must be a dependence upon God. When the devotion of God, you got to depend on God. When Job opened his mouth, it was not to complain or whine. I just wonder, you ain't got 10 kids, but I just wonder if you lost your kid. I just wonder if you lost your spouse. I just wonder, are you going to complain or why? Now, I'm not telling you not to grieve. I'm not telling you that. Remember, I told you it's okay to grieve. Remember, I told you the stages of grief. Remember, I told you the byproduct of what happened with grief. But then for us with the faith, I just want to ask you, are you thanking God in the midst of what you're going through? Yeah. Grief will make you quit. Grief will make you cry. Grief will make you run. Grief will make you want some names. But I'm telling you, the best name to call on is the name of Jesus. Why? Because you can depend on God. You can depend on God. When he spoke, it was the praises of the Lord and declared his continued dependence upon the power and the will of God. When I think my mic tried to play out on me. Every trial that you have is a trial good for you. Every bad situation that you're going through is good for you. You say, man, what do you mean it's good for me? It's good that I had a flat. It's good I had a cutoff notice. It's good I had a trial. It's good I had some trouble. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, it's good. I tell you, it's good. What you're going through is good for you. Wait a minute, Reverend. I'm ready to fight you now. You don't know what I'm going through. Yeah, you only knew what I'm going through. But I want to tell you, everything that you're going through is good for you. Why would you say that? I'm going to tell you that because Romans 8 and 28 says, for we know that all things work together for the good for them that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. So what you're going through is good for you because God is working behind the scenes for you. So the trouble that you're going through, God is working it out in order for him to get the glory. God is merely molding you and shaping you as you're going through. So we must not only be devoted to God, we must not only depend on God, but we must be diligent to God. While it is true that men are not trusting, while it is true that men are to trust in the Lord for everything, we are still to expect to do all we can. Now, just because you're going through don't mean that you got to sit in ashes all by yourself. I'm going to work this text out the way I want to. But notice in Job 2 and 8, we find Job sitting in ashes. And while Job is sitting there in ashes, the Bible says that he takes a piece of broken potter and began to scrape his sores. I just want to tell somebody, you may be broken, but God can even use the broken pieces in your life to help you. So the Bible tells us, the Bible says that Job sitting in a pile of ashes, scraping his sores with a piece of broken potter. He can't do much, but even in the valley, he's doing all that he can. Tell yourself, I can do all that I can. Never allow your problems and your trials to cause you to quit. I know. And I'm young, but I'm old. I'm 53, but I'm young. You can catch me on one day, I'm 53. The next day, I'll be 35. It's just whatever. It's just whatever. It's just however you want to put it. You know, I told my wife, let me tell you, she listened. I told my wife, yesterday, she said, oh, you old, you 53. I said, well, it's just a matter. I can be 35. I said, won't you turn yours around? Either you 49 or 94. Okay, let's get back to the message. All right? Listen, I want to share with you. You can depend on God. Be diligent in your walk with the Lord, and he will surely bless you for his glory. Notice that Job uses a piece of broken pottery to scrape himself. Contained in the image in a very great blessing from the Lord. This lesson is, those who have been broken can be used by the Lord. Because all of us has been broken. All of us have been broken into pieces. When you have been through the valley, you know how to help others. You know, I guarantee you, there's a room full of people that has a gift to help others through situations that you've been through. God has brought you through some dark times in order for you to be light to someone else. You didn't know how you were going to make it, but God brought you through. And now your friends are going through what you've been through, and you can say to them, I know how to trust God in the midst of it. And then can I just help some of us for just a moment? You ain't even got to say nothing. They just see how you respond through your trials, and it blesses them to be a blessing while they're going through their trials. Because some of the greatest messages that we preach are those that we do without words. So when you've been through the valley, you know how to help others who are coming out long behind you. Remember, when you're in the valley, to learn all the lessons with God wants you to teach you. Then when you come through the valley, you will help others. And then, not only was Job devoted, not only did Job depend on God, not only was Job diligent, but Job declared about God. I just want to ask you, when is the last time you told somebody, thank God for taking me through that valley? Thank God for allowing that to happen to me. Throughout his ordeal, Job never badmouthed God. Because it's so easy to badmouth God. I don't know about you, but God's been too good to me for me to even think about badmouthing him. He never stopped praising the Lord. Even during his darkest hour of trial, the greater the faith is our view. Job reminds us in Job 1 and 21, the Bible says that, and he said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. The Lord giveth, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I just want to ask you today, would you do me well to remember that one of our sure ways out of the valley is to exalt the name of the Lord. Now, it brings me, as I get ready to close, to bringing to think about what Mr. Job would say to each and every one of us. I want you to visualize this today and see, as we got 10 caskets that are lined up here. Here we have 10 caskets, and Job has got the good news. I know if I rush over to chapter 42 of Job, verse number 10, it would tell you that God gave Job double for his trouble. But sometimes we can't see the double because of the trouble. But I just want to ask somebody today, can you see God getting ready to bless you double for your trouble? Many times when we're sitting here in front of our trouble, we can't see the blessing. But I want to tell somebody today that you got to see the blessing even in the midst of your trouble. So no matter how trouble comes your way, can I remind you that trouble don't last always? Do I got a witness in the house? Anybody that can testify that I've had some trouble, but I've came through the trouble to remind me that trouble don't last always? Well, Reverend, how can you know that trouble don't last always? Well, because I have a Savior that came down through 42 generations, and they stretched him wide on an old cross called Calvary. They put nails in his hand, but he knew that trouble didn't last always. He knew that the nails couldn't hold him to the cross. He knew that the blood was coming down to wash away your sins and mine. He knew that when they pierced him in the side, it was pain for just a moment, because if they put him in the grave, that he was going to rise in 3 days. And that's why I want to remind you that in your grief situation, that you can rise again. I want to remind you, as you go through your stages of grief, that you got to continue to trust God. Is there anybody here today that can say, in the midst of what you're going through, I can look to the hills from which cometh my help, because all of my help cometh from the Lord? Job said, naked I came in this world, and naked I'm going to leave out of this world. And I want to suggest to some of y'all today, I know the songwriter wrote a song that was so amazing to say, I can only imagine. I'm here to tell you that you must imagine that one day they're going to have a casket here with you in it. And when that dude bring that in there, will you hear God say, well done, thou a good and faithful servant? I just want to suggest to some of us today that even as we're here to visit Brother Job in his funeral, but let me just pause for just a moment. Can I call heaven and ask to speak to Job? Hey, let me call him up. Yo, 111. Hey, Job, I don't know where you at in heaven, but Job, can I just talk to you for just a moment? Can I just have a talk with Job for just a moment? Well, Job, I lost my sister, Job. And Job, I lost two of my uncles, Job. I just lost another auntie, Job. And Job, I had to preach all of those funerals. But in the midst of it, Job, you taught me something, Job. Job, I don't know how it was over 2,000 plus years ago they wrote this text about you. But Job, what is it, Job, that gave you strength to be able to bury your 10 children? Job, what is it, Job, that gave you strength that even when you got the bad news, Job, you was able to worship God? Job, I just need to hear from you. Well, one of the things that I realize is, Pastor, is that I realized that what I was reading, I believe. What I realize is that what they were telling me, I had to act on. I realized that I lost all my finances. I lost my family. I lost my friends. I lost a lot of stuff. I even lost my health. He said, you remember over in chapter 1, sitting down with my friends, and he said, the best thing that my friend did for me is the 7 days that they sit there and didn't say a word. He said, what they messed up was after the 7 days, they started trying to blame me for sin. I didn't do anything wrong. All I was doing was trusting God. I was believing that God would make a way. And Job, wait a minute, Job. You mean to tell me, Job? Yeah, man, I lost it all. But now don't forget, you read the text. My wife was even speaking foolish. She told me to curse God and die. But I had to keep on looking up into the hills from which cometh my help. Wait a minute, Job. How did you make it? Well, I made it because I trust God. So if I had one word to tell you before I get back to praising the angels up here, I would tell you to trust God. I would tell you, no matter how bad it look, keep on trusting God. I would tell you how bad, I don't care what you're going through, keep on trusting God. I would tell you, I don't care if you got to walk through the valley all by yourself, you just got to keep on trusting God, because God will make a way. way out of no way. Can I tell you that when you trust God, no matter what you're going through, God will open doors for you. When you trust God, he'll provide for you. You just got to believe it. So you mean to tell me, Job, I'm kind of confused, because you got the bad news, Job. You had one servant came and told you that you lost your cattle, and you didn't say nothing. You had another servant came and told you that you lost this cattle. You didn't say nothing. Job said, you know what? The reason I was able to praise God in the midst of it is because I praised him before I got to it. Can I just tell somebody in the house, if you trust God before trouble come, when trouble come, you will keep on trusting God. Oh, can I tell you again? When you trust God before trouble, because just as sure, you may not have no trouble right now, but you're going to run into some trouble. And when you run into trouble, what's going to come out of you is what you put in you. Wait a minute, Joe. You didn't just start praising God when you lost your children. Nope. I praised him before he gave them to me. So when he took them, I couldn't do nothing but praise him. I was raised over there, and before I got the cattle, I praised him. So when I lost the cattle, I still yet praised him. Wait a minute, Joe. You make it seem so easy. Well, it is easy when you're dependent on God. It's very easy when you trust in God. You mean to tell me, Job, that you danced around at the funeral? Job said, no, I danced around before I got to the funeral. When I got to the funeral, I couldn't do nothing but praise him, because I was thinking, if it had not been for the Lord on my side. Can I just tell you, as we finish this day on grief today, I just wanted to take you to Job's house. I just want to take you down Job's Boulevard to show you that even in the midst of your grieving, you got to trust God. You've got to trust God. Can I just pick on one person? I'm going to pick on her today. Miss Wilma Robinson, one of the Nash girls. Her husband died. She's married for 50 plus years. I was up that way. In the midst of it, she wasn't happy that he died. But you know what she said? She said, I'm 80. I think he was 79 then. Because you're 80 something now, right now. Still look good. 0880. Amen. We can take it either way.
Amen.
But yeah, but let me tell you what she did. She said, you know what? She said, Pastor, I'm sad. But I'm trusting God. She said, I'm trusting God. She said, in the midst of me losing my husband, I'm still yet thanking God. Now, I didn't ask her why, but she said, I'm thanking him because my husband is not suffering anymore. I'm thanking him because I'm trusting God. And then she probably don't remember this, but she said, my mother and my father raised, how many Nash girls is it? Eight? Nine. He raised nine of us girls. Wasn't no boys, nine girls to trust God. Now see what happened was, now 50 years later after marriage, 80 years later after life, she lost her husband of 50 years. She was able to tell me, I'm trusting God because of what her mama and daddy instilled in her. Amen. To that when she was young.
Amen.
Listen, how was she able to say that? Because it was in her.
Amen.
Listen, I want to tell you in closing, you can make it. You know why you can make it? Because it's in you. You have to pull out what's in you in the time of trouble. And let me tell you something, it's not easy in the valley, but you can trust God in the valley. I want to pray with you today. I want to pray with you. And I want to tell you that as you walk out of here today and face your valley, just remember all 10 of these castings that you saw today. And I'm going to tell you what I like about today. I didn't see any tears at Job's family funeral. I didn't see any tears. Not no tears. I saw so much laughter. I saw so much joy. And that's the way life is. Life is all about trusting God. And what you need is within you. I want to tell you today, as we continue to focus, anger, bargain, depressions, just remember, grief is normal. But as normal as grief is, trust. Just know that you can depend on God.